Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I am so glad you tuned in today. As you can see on the topic, what I'm about to discuss with us today is about what we need to know before we hire drivers in Nigeria. For those of us who stay in Nigeria and some of us who are in diaspora trying to relocate back to Nigeria or going for visiting for the meantime, these are the things we need to watch out for before we hire a driver, a personal driver, permanent or even if it's temporarily. These are the things we need to watch out for before we hire the drivers. This is what I'm talking about today, is what had happened to me, what I've experienced, and I would not want anybody else's to experience that. That is the reason why I am sharing it with us today. So we'll know all these things, and these are the things we need to watch out for before we are committed in hiring a driver. So the first thing we need to watch out for is, first, we need to get a reference from the driver we want to hire. Either if somebody recommends this driver to us, we also need to obtain a reference from this person. Either the reference may be a banker, may be a lawyer, just a person with, you know, a responsible person to stand for that driver, whichever thing the driver may have come, whichever thing comes up, or whichever thing the driver or the driver may have committed, or any sins the driver may have committed, you have somebody you want to hold responsible for whatever mischievousness they may have committed. So that is one thing we need to watch out for. We need to have a reference from the driver, obtain a reference from the driver. The second thing we need to watch out for is, we need to know the roads. The driver you're hiring needs to know the roads. Where he needs to be familiar with the roads, Lagos Road, anywhere in part of Nigeria, the driver needs to know the road. Because in my own experience, my driver did not know the road. Yes, what happened is that he was once staying in Lagos, he relocated back to Osun State where he lives, and then I think he lost some touches the roads, how to get to some particular places in Lagos. So he didn't know the road. So it's like both of us, I don't know the road in Lagos because I live in the UK. I just go to Nigeria back and forth. So I'm not familiar with the roads in Nigeria, even though I was born there and I grew up there, but I still don't know the road. And I left the country for some time, so I lost some touches. I don't know the road of Nigeria. So my driver left Lagos, Osun State, like I was saying, Lagos, Osun State, and then he doesn't know the road. So the drivers, as the employer, what you need to do is that if you're going to somewhere, you need to get your smartphone, download maps. Okay, download maps on your phone, type in your address where you're going in the whatever particular place you're going, so you have a backup. Even if your driver don't know the place, he may even pretend that you don't know where you're going, but you already have a backup with your phone because you have your map with you. So your map is directing you so that you know even if the driver is going to the right direction, of course, because some of these drivers, they can be very dubious by kidnapping us. Obviously, we know that. So we should be very, very vigilant with what we are doing. We should always make sure we know where we are going, even if we've left the country for a long time, we are going back there, we are going places. Just don't rely on the drivers. Always have a backup of yourself as well. Make sure you know the direction is you're going. It's just like you're having navigator in your phone. We do it in Europe, we do it in America. There is no point us not doing it in Nigeria and rely on the drivers and make them to be taking us to places that we are not familiar with, but we know where we are going. We have an appointment and then we are relying on them to take us to these places. So always make sure you have a backup, you have your phone with you to check where you're going, if it's going to the right direction. Even if it misses the road, you could say, oh, take this place, but don't make them know that you don't know where you're going. always be very, very pretend that you know the place that you're going. You know the place you're going, so that they will not be, that's for the for those of them, because we don't know which one we can even trust anyway. So, but we should always make sure we have a backup, that we know where we are going by relying on our phone. The third thing we need to know is that don't be too familiar with your driver. It is not the good thing. Don't expose yourself. Always make sure you are a private person. For example, if you're in the car, you got a phone call from your families, always make sure you don't talk about yourself, your family, in front of your driver, your business. Always be very, very private. Be a private person. Keep your distance. You don't want them to know much about you. You don't want them to lose respect for you, because, excuse me, when you continue doing this, they get too familiar, they get too confident with you, and then that respect, that distance, they would not want to keep that barrier. They will think that they can do anything and go away with it, because they already know you. There's no barrier of respect will be broken if you are too familiar with them. If you talk to them, it's not that you're going to be bad, to be rude to them, but you should always keep your distance. Keep your distance away from your driver. Don't be rude. Don't be rude with them. So just keep your distance. That's what I want to say. And then the next thing I want us to know is that don't let them take your car wherever you go. Like now, I normally commute from Lagos to Osun State. So my driver is based in Osun State. Before I got a recommendation from somebody, they brought him to Lagos. He was staying with me, so I commute from Lagos to Osun State. So he knows Osun State very well. I don't know Osun State. I'm a Lagosian born there, and I don't really know outside Lagos. So he knows a lot about outside Lagos. So that is another priority he has over me. So what he normally do whenever we leave Lagos going to Osun State, by the time we get to our destination in Osun State, he would have tampered with the car. So tampering with the car is that by the time we get to Osun State, you see, we need to fix this, we need to fix that, we need to fix this and that, that, that. So what they do is that sometimes they tamper with your vehicle, because I may be taking my bath, and then they will just take the car away and say, oh, they're taking it for a run, or they're taking it for something. They just create an excuse for you. You'll be thinking that, oh, the driver is being good, is trying to check, but whereas they would have gone out to do something with the vehicle. So by the time you get there, it is just that sometimes it may be they may unscrew something, like the incident that I have with my driver. It tampered with the window handle, you know, the manual one. It's not the automatic, we have the manual one. So what he did is that he tampered with that. So every time we try to do something, it's something that happened to it. It doesn't wind up properly. I don't know what they did, even with the handle. They just create something so that they will have money from, they'll get money from you, so that they will say, okay, madam, well, I want to go and fix it. So this is what happened, because they already know what they've done to the car. So they would want to get that money from you. So they do a lot of things. Either they touch the car handles as well. They touch so many, they just do something to the car, but they already know what they've done there. So as a woman, we don't know much about vehicles. Men may have an idea, but they always do it to female employers. So always make sure you know this stuff. You don't want them to take it away to say, oh, they want to go and do something with it. And another thing, don't allow your drivers to know or to have a personal relationship with your mechanic. It is very important. If you have a mechanic, you should be the one to have your own contact with your mechanic. Don't exchange contact numbers with your drivers and with the mechanic. Don't exchange numbers with for them. Don't give your mechanic numbers or your driver's mechanic's number, you know, vice versa. Don't give them their number. Don't let them be personal with each other. Don't let them know each other. All you need to do, if you want to service your car, just say, you know, so person, go and drop this vehicle at my mechanic's place. Let them, you know, do. And always make sure your mechanic is the one talking to you, not them. Don't let them know each other. And as well, always make sure you have respect for them. Have respect for your drivers. You don't have to be mean with them. You don't have to be rude to them. Like I said earlier, be discreet. Keep your distance. Don't be too familiar. You know, all these drivers, they know a lot about. Even if you don't talk about yourself in front of them, they can see what you do every day on a daily basis. They know your movement. They know where you're going. All these things, you have to be very careful who you are dealing with, how you're dealing with them, how you're talking to them. Because all these things, they know so many things about you. Not personal thing. That's why I said, don't make them know personal things about you. But your movement, they know it. And we can be easily be a target if they know much about us. They are easily to kidnap us, isn't it? But God forbid that would not happen. We can be very careful not to allow this to happen. Be nice to them. Don't talk down at them. Don't abuse them. Just be not that extremely. You have to have policies, because without policies, these drivers will not respect you. But just let them know that this is your yes, this is your no. And don't be too Mr. Nice Guy with them. If they come to you and say, madam, something is wrong with my family, sometimes some of them lies. So don't be too Mr. Nice Guy or goody-goody two-shoe boss. Goody-goody two-shoe boss is not the best with Nigerian driver, honestly. You have to be strict, at the same time be nice. Those are the things that I want us to know today about drivers in Nigeria. I hope this video is able to help somebody. If you have any question you need to ask me regarding this, please put a comment down below. I'm happy to help you. I'm happy to answer any question. And if you have not subscribed to my channel, what are you still waiting for? Please subscribe to my channel. I bring so much reality talk shows, reality things that happens to me, that happens to people around me, that happens to people that I know, real stuff. So that whatever had happened to people that I know, people that happened to me, I'll be able to share it with you so that you will not be able to go to such situation as well. Thank you so much for watching me. And please give it a thumbs up if you like this video. If this video helps you, give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I love you. Bye-bye. Kindly subscribe to my channel. This encourages me to do more videos. And please don't forget to press the bell to get notification anytime I drop new videos. Thank you.